This Christmas, as you spend time with family and friends, eating your favourite Christmas goodies, enjoying the treats you may have had to do without throughout another tough year, as you let your hair down, your belts out, and open up your wallets to spoil those you love the most, spare a thought for the 20,000 homeless people who are living on the streets in southeast Queensland alone, who have nothing this Christmas, or who are right now living in substandard conditions. There'll be people who started out just like you and I, with a job, a family, even friends, who now, for whatever reason, find themselves with nothing. No food, no shelter, no hope. Your circumstances can change so quickly. On top of the world one minute, struggle street the next. Hi, my name's Liam Renton. That's me right there, a radio DJ from 96.5 in Brisbane. I wanted to see what life under the stars was like, so I chose to sleep rough on the streets for an entire week, in an effort to highlight the services, or lack of, available to the homeless in their own backyard. With the help of some mates, a Brisbane Bronco, an Olympic gold medalist, and a charity CEO, we slept as homeless men on the streets of Brisbane for 1 week. Nights huddled under any shelter we could find, early mornings broadcasting a daily radio show after a tough night, sharing my homeless experiences with the listeners of Brisbane, giving the city an insight to what the silent suffering go through daily. Now the rules, we could only live on the services currently available to the homeless in the city. We weren't allowed to have any cash and had to find our own place to sleep on the streets under the stars.
I guess that the point of the week is to live on the provisions of stuff that's available to homeless in the city. Tim, City Care hand out Homeless Connect packs to those in need. Why don't we run through what we're going to be living on and using for the week, okay, and how we'll actually use this stuff every day.
Sure.
Yep.
Probably the most important thing is the backpack. So most people, that's all they have. I mean, it's either in the shopping trolley or it's in the backpack. So the backpack is the primary product. Then you've got the sleeping bag. Now these are quality bags. They are actually about -5 degree temperature. And with our weather of late, we're actually going to need them.
Brisbane charity City Care provide help and support to thousands of families doing it tough each year. To receive any assistance, you've got to first register as a person in need.
Have you got your Centrelink card with you today?
No.
You haven't?
No.
Do you have any identification? We need to have identification. Yeah. If I could have some identification, thank you.
Yep. It's an interesting experience to be interviewed. What I find weird is being left alone with a room full of stuff that you could take, steal and maybe sell off later, like you're just alone in here.
Here,
blankets
in this cupboard.
I'll have
them,
I might see you again soon.
And don't forget to come back if you need anything else.
Okay.
So I had officially registered myself as a homeless person and was given my supplies for survival for free.
Interesting feeling answering questions about your life and being homeless and where you live. Obviously, there's a bit of role playing going on, but I got sucked into it bad. Like, I didn't really want to talk. You know, I think that male chauvinistic stubbornness might have kicked in a bit, and I was embarrassed to talk to her, and I don't know how other guys would do it who are living out on the street. She was lovely and really warm and caring, which was nice, and I guess, you know, just concerned that I hadn't eaten, which I haven't eaten yet, so I'm going to get my first meal, which she's given me here. What have we got here? It's got some goodies, some milk, some vitamins, some some chocolates, some frozen bread, which I don't know what I'll do with yet, and a blanket for tonight. That's it's a good service, but you walk out and you think, well, where to from here?
Now, preparing yourself for life on the streets is pretty hard. You're on your own, left to fend for yourself, and you're not quite sure of how this thing's going to end up, or where it was I'd actually sleep that night. And you're always wondering, how safe you're really going to be? I'd been given a tarp for shelter and was off to the 139 Club for a cheap feed. $3 a meal.
Just a little bit of pumping. Yeah.
Thank you.
You want me a ticket?
Sure.
Where do I get my dessert from? Come back for that? Yeah. It's nice.
Not too big one for me, Barry.
Not too big.
No, as you can see, it's slim.
I get a bit funny about the cleanliness. I mean, you know, hope they're all clean. I'm sure they are.
Exercise.
I'll give them a quick wipe before I eat. It's good.
Yeah, BP's.
A really nice pasta dish and really nice pumpkin. It's only $3.
Pumpkin is to die for.
But it's really tasty. And a lot of it. I'm really impressed. I'd eat this at home. Well, not as good as this. This is really good. There's a lot of love put to making this.
I'd gotten the help of a couple of mates to sleep out with me. Former Bronco legend Benny Ikin, Olympic gold medalist Duncan Armstrong, and CityCare CEO Tim Bean.
Well, I think tonight's going to be different. I'm glad I've got good company, some good people around me. That's probably one thing that the homeless people in Brisbane or homeless people anywhere don't really have. But we're going to be sort of semi-warm, semi-comfortable. We are going to be on the streets. There's going to be cars driving past. I don't know how well I'll sleep, but I'll wake up in the morning know that I've done a small bit and played a small role to help shine a light on the struggles that some of the people go through here in my hometown.
Did you sort of separate under any circumstances?
I didn't think that was part of the job.
That's it.
Thank you.
That's yours. Jacket included.
Thank you.
And all the necessary gear for tonight. If we go wandering, just keep it with you. Don't leave it lying around, because it'll
go.
Well,
walking down here tonight, I was a little bit apprehensive because I got down here about 4:30 in the afternoon, and you know, the valley isn't the easiest place to walk through without seeing some sights and sounds you don't really see on you every day. So actually walking down here, I got quite apprehensive about what to expect and being out here. But since being down to Rosie's soup kitchen, I'm pretty relaxed about it now. Got some good people around us, and we'll just see what the night brings. We're on pretty busy streets. And it'll be interesting to see how the different stages of the night go, and how much sleep we get, and how safe you feel, and what kind of an education we're going to get tonight. So it'll be pretty interesting, but I'm looking forward to it.
Local charity Street Swags provide free sleeping swags for the homeless. They try and keep the homeless alive long enough until the community, that's you and me, can take responsibility for their own. Each swag is funded by local donations. There's not a lot to do on the streets, so we found a perch to call home for the night, set up our makeshift beds, and chatted about the important issues affecting Brisbane's homeless, like who'd win the footy this weekend. Well, we were in the company of a former Bronco.
Yeah, we had lunch with some fairly ill homeless men and women, and that was a bit of an eye-opener. Good to see there are some good services around town that are looking after people and that care about people. And we want to support that and encourage that. No one else is doing it, and they're doing a good job. Thankful that it's not as cold tonight, but can only imagine that when it does get cold, it would be a tough night on the street. I mean, we're on the street, but we've got it pretty good. I expect it to be loud, and it's quite confronting with the road right there, that people can walk past, can yell, can jump a fence, come and say good day. So there'll be a little bit of trepidation as you go to bed, maybe sleeping with one eye open until we just pass out. Looking forward to a good night's sleep.
Coming up, the media catch on to what we were doing when Under the Stars continues. I'm a radio DJ who chose for 1 week to live on the streets using the services only available to the city's homeless. A week living on the streets was the challenge. No money, no support, sleeping rough on the concrete. And the media were keen to see what life on the streets was really like.
An Origin footballer, an Olympian and a radio DJ have spent the night sleeping on the streets of Brisbane. They're trying to raise enough tinned food to feed 10,000 people.
Monday night in Brisbane, and a growing number of people are sleeping on the footpath and lining up for soup. Joining them last night, former Bronco Ben Ikin, Olympic gold medalist Duncan Armstrong, and Liam Renton from 96.5.
Yes, we think people are going to be cynical of what we're trying to do, but at least we're trying.
The trio bedded down in Fortitude Valley, aware no matter how bad it would get, it's worse for the 450 people who call the streets of inner Brisbane home.
We'll never get to experience the hopelessness, you know, that feeling of having nobody, nobody to turn to, not having a roof over your head, and I guess more than anything, not knowing how long the hopelessness will last.
Around 2 a.m. it got uncomfortable.
We thought we were doing okay until it started to rain, and then it just went all downhill from there.
An unwelcome visitor scared them at 3.
You have a newfound understanding, I think, of the insecurity you have on the street. It's just, it's intense.
Not a terrible night's sleep. I could put up with the fact that the traffic was loud, that was alright. I could put up the fact that it was a little bit cool, I could snuggle, curl up. It was the rain that got me. It started coming down about 1 o'clock. I was right in the middle of it. And we got wet. Yep, very wet. But that wasn't good. The rain did me in. I can do the cold, I can do the noise, but just not being dry. And we were under a cover as well. Yeah. Got wet, and I guess, you know, this is night one, and now I've got to work the next couple of hours, so I don't know how you'd have nowhere to sleep and then get up and try and have a job. That'd be too hard. You couldn't do it. So I guess this morning's show will be a true telltale sign as to how possible it really is.
This morning from Barry Parade in the Valley, we've taken the family show to the streets of Brisbane. We start this morning, Duncan Armstrong, Olympic gold medalist, is with us. We kind of got a little wet last night. It wasn't too bad. Could have been a lot worse.
Yeah, it could have been a lot worse. But it gave us a bit of a taste of how the conditions can change and how homeless people can be caught out in those conditions and the consequences of that. Because, you know, there, like I said before, there's no dryers, there's no washing machines. If you get wet, you just have to dry out.
Well, all the fun and excitement of the radio show's over. Everyone packs up and goes home, and then I'm left here. This is where I slept last night. Got a sleeping bag. In fact, absolutely wet. And it doesn't look like we're roughing it too bad. We've got it better than most. But we did get wet, and right now I'm a bit cold. Haven't eaten this morning. And it's all about going around and trying to find my first meal of the day. So I'm not quite sure what I'm going to eat. I know there's a free lunch on today. I'll find that. And then I've got hours to kill. Now you are really, really bugging. Yes, you are bugging me. Medicine are wrong. Yesterday I came here for a meal and it cost me $3, and today it's free, so it's worth the walk up the road. But, hey mate, someone's giving me the forks in the background, it's for the life. It's worth the walk to get a free meal. Yesterday it was nice, pasta and pastrami, hopefully today will be nice as well. We'll check it out. Jeez, this poncho, as dry as it's keeping me, it's making me hot with all the sweat.
Most nights of the week, you'll actually find at least one charity providing a free meal, some more basic than others, whether it's soup, hot dogs or coffee. Between the city's churches and charities, they cover most nights of the week in an effort to help feed the homeless. I really got a good excuse to complain. My parents got divorced, can't heal the pain. And now there is only change. It was amazing to meet people who live on the street, all with a story to tell, if you just give them a chance. Is it the world or how I see me? For now you are me.
I probably came into it thinking it was going to be like a camping trip, but having spent the day as an incognito homeless person, mixing with the everyday guys on the street, hearing the stories and enjoying their camaraderie, it's harder than I thought it would be. And I only imagine it will get harder over the next couple of days. Worrying about where you're going to eat, getting more protective of my bed, that someone's not going to come and take it in the middle of the day and steal my stuff. Just isn't even my stuff, it was given to me, but I'm getting really protective of the little luxuries I do
have.
Long
day, challenging day, thought-provoking day, and I think that all helps us to consider just our position. You know, we've got it well, we're rich, we're well off, we're safe, and we're trying to assimilate with those who have none of the above. So I think that's all good, and I'm looking forward to trying to get some sort of sleep tonight.
Still to come, the greatest gift a charity can offer a homeless man, plus living rough starts to take its toll. I'm a radio DJ who chose for 1 week to live on the streets using the services only available to the city's homeless.
Just woke up. I probably had a better night's sleep than the night before because I was so tired I just passed out. But it was the most uncomfortable night's sleep. Just on the concrete, and my knees are on the concrete. And it was colder than it has been. It was a cold night, an uncomfortable night. And I can feel my throat's a bit sore. And I probably look haggard. Do I look haggard? I look haggard. Okay, that's nice. So it was just a pretty rough night. Not as many trucks went by, not as many dogs were barking, but just cold and uncomfortable. I just want to get up and go for a walk around and stretch my legs, and I've got an hour to kill if we go on the radio. Or I could just go back to sleep for a bit. Just give me 5 more minutes.
This is day 3. We're live in the valley for the entire week. Pretty much sleeping out every night. We've got a team of guys that every night are sleeping down here on the concrete, on a cardboard box on the concrete here in the valley.
I met a guy just today who said that the worst thing he felt was looking shabby. You know, he was homeless and he looked in the mirror one day and he said his hair was long, he didn't like his clothes, and he made a decision there and then that every time he left the house from now on, he was going to at least slick his hair back, at least get rid of the 3-day growth and wear respectable clothes downtown. I just feel like crap right now. I feel dirty, I feel yucky, just disgusting. I want to get this shirt off. I haven't changed my jocks in 3 days. I stink, and I just want a shower. And I can get a shower, I've been told, which I'm going to try and get now, but there's still nowhere to wash my clothes, so I'm putting dirty clothes back on. But I just want to get out of what I'm wearing and find somewhere to make me feel a little more self-respected. I just want to feel better about myself. I just feel grotty. And, you know, I don't want to shake anyone's hand because I feel grotty, and I don't want to look anyone in the eye because I'm a bit disrespectful, you know. Ran into some mates this morning who said, geez, you know, look at your hair. You always wash your hair every day. Yeah, well, where do I wash my hair now? I don't know. So I want to get a shower under my belt and hopefully feel better about myself.
Local charity City Care offer the occasional shower to those in desperate need and hand out homeless packs to men and women who register as being in need. They gave me some soap and a battery-powered razor for a shave so I could at least try and gain some self-respect. It's pretty easy to get dirty and feel pretty crummy sleeping on concrete. Free community lunches and dinners see rooms full of homeless people gather almost daily somewhere in the city for a feed, some company, and a welcome break from the outdoors.
Great soup kitchen that does a really nice meal. We just had roast lamb with some gravy and some mud cake for dessert and just shared it with about 50 other guys. They ran out of food halfway through the meal. Just felt really guilty because we'd already eaten ours and some went without and we didn't need to eat. But just what an awesome organisation that put on a free meal every night. And you can see the guys over my shoulder enjoying themselves right now. Had some good food. Got a good nap under a tree in a park. And now I'm about to go to sleep outside the men's toilets. Back up early nice tomorrow for the show. Let's hope we can string a couple of words together.
Still to come on Under the Stars, things get tough and take a turn for the worse.
Because when you're on the street, and I've only done it for a couple of days,
you just don't, you don't feel good about yourself, you know.
You're watching Under the Stars, what it's like to leave the comfort of your job, home and a warm bed and choose to sleep rough, living on the streets for one entire week.
Sore back, sore ear, bad hair, haggard, I want my own bed, tired, busting to go to the toilet. I want a bit of security, a bit of warmth. I'm that tired that nothing really wakes me up. You get woken up a couple of times throughout the night with noises and a bit of cold, and it's just damp. You wake up and it's damp. It's not terrible, but it's just not nice. And it's cold. It's cold. And I'm going to try and just put my thoughts together and then do the show today. But before I do the show, I'll put my shoes on. And before I do that, I've got to find a toilet.
After sleeping on concrete in the valley, I'd be up to do a live radio show telling Brisbane what homelessness was really like. CityCare CEO Tim Bean took me for a walk in the valley to see the help Hallelujah Shoes offer homeless people. Hallelujah Shoes is a charity that provides work for the homeless to help them get back on their feet and back into the workforce.
We usually start with Work for the Dole. We do Work for the Dole training. We privately mentor people. We just take people who perhaps they don't qualify for a Work for the Dole project or they finish their mutual obligation. We'll mentor them ourselves. We'll cover their expenses for training. I mean, we meet people and we'll work with them for a couple of weeks or a couple of months and we'll just get them a job and that's the last we see of them. But we have some really interesting cases where we might work with people for 6 or 8 months, and maybe the outcome of that training is that they actually come in and apologise for having a bad attitude. And that's like, you know, we all throw a party, major breakthrough, you know, they've realised there's other people here. But sometimes that's the only outcome we get. Or they may learn how to interact socially. It's not a drop-in centre, but we get people that will work with us on a long-term basis. So 3 months as a Work for the Dole project sometimes doesn't get the outcome that we're looking for. So that's where we privately mentor them, and CityCare obviously backs us in that.
You might have known that local businesses help the city's homeless where they can, with free meals, coffees and handouts. There's a lot of good people in this city whose generous heart really makes a difference, as we found out at Gloria Jean's.
We've missed everybody for lunch. 139, we've missed Pindari. So either we get some food free or we have to use what little cash the guys have got. So Gloria Jean's, good support of CityCare. We've sent clients to them in various states before. And so we hit up the owner or the store manager for the day, and he's been able to help the guys out. But your reaction is interesting. Why?
Just felt really bad. Like you're getting something for free, and you're appreciative of that, but your self worth goes out the door with it, and you don't want to make eye contact.
No eye contact. No.
You don't feel worthy to be receiving help. You'd almost rather not take the food.
It's interesting to hear from this. He didn't even walk. No. I said there's a couple of guys sleeping rough. They're guests of ours. And they don't know who you are. And he was no questions asked. But for us, it's based on relationship. Like he trusts us, we trust them. I actually didn't know how to handle it when you were going to say no. It's just like, oh, what am I going to do then? So I just need to think about what are the implications of sometimes being charitable. It's got to come with some understanding of what's on the other end. And something may not be there.
Coming up on Under the Stars, how you can help as I start to realise what the city's homeless really need and what a difference you at home can really make. Go take a step outside. Shaking in the real world. Go take a step outside. See what's shaking in the real world. Welcome back to Under the Stars. My name's Liam Renton, and I chose to sleep on the streets as a homeless person for a whole week. No money, no support, no food or shelter. And to be quite honest, it became the hardest week of my life.
It's been interesting, you know, living as a homeless person. Because I actually really feel like I have been homeless. I wouldn't have say I've done it as tough as those on the street. You know, the bedding's been fine, but lining up in soup kitchens for meals, you know, I've done that. And I've had to swallow pride. Accepting help, I've done that. That's hard. Sitting in a room of 100 people and not having a conversation with anyone, I did that. And that's really lonely. And you try and process everything you take in. And what do you do with all this? Where to from here? How can I take now what I've learnt and done and do something practical with it? And I guess there's a couple of practical steps that I would take away from instantly from doing this. And one of those would be interaction. If it's one thing that's just killed me every day, it's hours of boredom and loneliness. And, you know, a lot of the streeties say, why do you think we get into drugs and booze? Because we're bored and we just want to numb the hours of the day until night falls and we go to sleep. I can kind of see why you'd do that. When there's nothing to do, nowhere to go, just killing time. Nothing to do. I fell asleep under a tree in a park out in the open. I could have woken up, someone could have been bashing me or stealing my stuff, you know. Don't know how safe it was, but just bored, just passed out. And I guess, you know, taking away instant stuff like interacting with other people. I sat at a homeless kitchen the other night and I sat beside this guy for 10 minutes while I was eating and he was eating. We didn't say a word to each other. And then I turned to him just out of the blue and just said, what have you been doing? Straight away, we struck up a conversation. He just turned to me and said, oh, I went fishing last week. Geez, they're not biting like they used to. Straight away, we just had a conversation, and it was excellent. It was great. It was raw, and it was emotive, and I was lonely, and he was lonely. And, you know, there's self-worth in giving people your time. And I just think that's the key, you know? Loving other people is what it's all about. Yeah. It's easier to say you love people, but just practically loving people. Like asking someone genuinely how their day is. And I'm not just talking about street people either, you know. I've kind of come up with a bit of a theory about loneliness and depression, how the two may be linked. You know, if you're lonely and you've got no one in your life at all, you're just downward spiral. You've got no one to talk to, you've got no one to vent to, you've got no one to ask you how your day is. You just feel cruddy all the time. So I would like to think that I'd walk away from this with a more personal intent on wanting to have relationships with people and quality relationships, conversations about life, love, whatever. You know, if you see someone that isn't as well-dressed as you are or isn't as, you know, in your circle or whatever, don't be afraid to shake their hand. Don't be afraid to pat them on the back. Don't be afraid to show them love, you know. You don't have to do much to show people that you care about them. And just converse with people. Ask someone how their day is. You might not get a sane conversation. You might not get an answer. You might not get anything in return. But to build into people's lives, you know, to help build people's self-worth in one conversation, I reckon is really important. Because when you're on the street, and I've only done it for a couple of days, you don't feel good about yourself. You know, I'm a really confident guy with a great job, a great wife, and a really happy life. But I don't feel like that this week. I just feel awful, you know. And I know I'm confident in life, but I'm not at the moment. And that'll change after I go home and have a shower and spend the night, you know, talking to my wife about what I've done and her words of encouragement. But people don't have that. I think it's everyone's responsibility to do that to other people. Just talk to people. Ask them how their day is. Ask them if they can do something for them. You'll impact them. You'll change them. You'll give them self-worth and you'll make them feel so good about themselves. And I just reckon that's what people need. They just need love. Everybody needs love.
When Under the Stars continues, how a random stranger tips me over the edge and brings me to tears. It gets real embarrassing and the cracks start to appear next.
I don't know what to do for other people, but it makes me want to just give.
G'day, I'm Liam Renton, a radio announcer on 96.5 in Brisbane. living as a homeless man for a week, then broadcasting a live radio show from the streets daily. After 4 days, I was complaining on air that with no cash in my pocket, I was craving soft drink, when a random stranger tracked me down with a little surprise.
It makes me... it's so humbling for me that you'd just come in and bring me a bottle of Coke.
It's okay.
Which is all I wanted today. And, I've got no cash to buy one.
No. So you don't need cash.
So someone would do that. Yeah. That really means a lot to me. Thank you so much.
We dropped cans off for the family, and I thought, Liam's just be hanging for a can of Coke, so I got your can of Coke.
I really have.
Yeah, it's all right. People love you that you don't even know, man. And everybody, and everyone on the street, and everybody that's out here that lives this and does it every day, you know, like a smile, everyone's loved. You always feel sorry and wish you could do more, and you feel guilty even, you know, that you got what you got.
And, you know, I've done this for 5 days. Yeah. You know, big walk. I go home tomorrow.
Yeah.
I'm going straight to a 60-litre bath.
Yeah.
I'm going to put on a nice shirt that my wife bought me.
Yeah.
I put my wedding ring and my watch back on that I haven't worn all week. Then I'm going to go out to an all-you-can-eat smorgasbord for lunch.
Yeah.
I feel guilty.
You do, because you got the opportunity, and that's the problem. Where does it end? The people with compassion, you can't give enough, you know what I mean? But the more people that know, the easier it'll be.
But you know what it makes me think? It makes me think those that have should, you know.
Of course.
If you've got it, it's your, you know, you've got to help others.
Give it. I am my brother's keeper.
Yeah.
You know, that's it. Simple as that. We are here to love and look after and help everybody that we can while we're here.
And you know, the hardest thing about this is not sleeping out, you know, I can sleep on concrete forever. It doesn't bother me. I can sleep out in the cold river.
Yeah.
The hardest thing is lack of interaction.
Excellent.
You know, they talk about people being locked away in solitary confinement. I always wondered about that. Thought, oh, yeah, I'd be right. No way. I would go stir crazy.
It's like another form of discrimination, isn't it, being homeless and poor? It's like people don't like to think we discriminate, but people do discriminate. We do look down on the poor and the unfortunate as if it's something they can control, as if it was their choice. I mean, give me a drug addict or someone on the street that it's really been entirely their choice to do this. And it'll be one in a million, I'd say.
Hey, it just starts with a handshake. You made my day.
I'm going to give you that.
Good on you, brother.
You're worth more money.
Thank you.
Give your missus and your dog a big kiss and a cuddle.
Mate,
have a bath. Don't feel guilty and do as much as you can, because you've done heaps. And we all love you very much at 96.5.
Thank you very much.
All right. Enjoy your cake.
Mate, it's going to be a nice drink, I tell you what. Thank you very much.
Have a good one. You've done a great job.
Thank you.
Thanks, Steve.
Unbelievable. That's really generous. It's a bottle of Coke. It's really generous, and it makes me want to go and just do stuff for other people. I don't know what to do for other people, but it makes me want to just give. Not even cash, you know. It just makes me want to give. With it, just time. Just give time. Just chat to people. Ask them how they are. See, brother. Just empower people. Because we can, you know. I'm going to savor every last drop of this. This is good.
Another night, another mission to track down a free feed. I was making new friends, homeless mates. Friends that didn't judge and had no expectations. Friends that were looking out for me, telling me where I could get a meal in my belly, a free coffee to keep warm, and to offer basic conversation when the outside world acted as if I, a guy with a job, and a quarter of a million radio listeners didn't even exist. To the real world, I was homeless. No one seemed to care. No one gave me a second glance, a hello, even the time of day. My self-esteem was at an all-time low. I felt after only a week of no contact with family and friends that no one actually loved me anymore, and I was all alone. The loneliness was doing me in. I was well and truly over it. I just wanted to go home and see my wife and dog. And with Christmas so close, most of us get this feeling deep in our hearts to want to help others in need, especially this time of year. So here are my top 3 tips on spreading the love this Christmas, because you can. Say hi to people. You probably sit on the train next to the same people every day. Say good day, start a conversation, and connect with someone new. Donate your time. There's plenty of charities who need willing, able bodies. It'll make you feel good, and you'll be helping out. Random acts of kindness. It sounds a little old school, but buying someone a meal or giving a homeless person $10 could make a massive difference. What was great to see over the week was local schools showing interest, with a bunch of local junior reporters coming down to see firsthand what homelessness was like and how their school could help.
How could school children help this appeal?
We'd love to get school kids involved with the Toucan Appeal. Now get your school together, put a notice in your notices and say, hey, everyone at school, bring two cans from your pantry into school, because if you go through your cupboards, you're going to find there's always some sort of can of baked beans or spaghetti or tuna in the back of the cupboard that you forget about. Everyone's got spare cupboards. It doesn't cost any money. Just ask mum and dad and say, can I take two cans to school? And if everyone at school brought in two cans, we'd get hundreds of thousands of cans, and that would feed hundreds of people that are homeless in the city.
Still to come, what did the city learn from seeing how the homeless live? And the current changes charities have made to make a difference and impact Brisbane's homeless and needy. Southeast Queensland alone has 20,000 homeless people sleeping rough. No family, friends, food or shelter. Our experiment was to live under the stars, on the streets for a week, living solely on the resources available to the city's needy.
Woken up, last day, good to go. Cold, a little bit damp. I'm waking everyone else up. Look at this guy, who's this guy sitting this way?
Oh, what the?
What we found was that even though so many charities do so much already to help those in need, there's always more that can be done. City Care has since set up Alfred's, a drop-in centre for the homeless, providing free showers, free haircuts, food and clothes to those in need every day of the week in Alfred Street, the Valley.
It's been a massive learning experience for all of us. We've had sports stars, radio personalities, and myself and just a few other people that are interested in being involved in a street sleep and trying to really get an understanding of what is it like to live on the street. And our worlds have all been transformed and challenged. We've started to see the insecurity, the loneliness, the isolation, and the frustration that so many people experience that are homeless. So Alfred's is up and running. 12 months down to the track, we've had an opening. It has been outstanding. And we are finding more and more people becoming aware of the services that we've had available to them. We've also developed the concept of the street chaplains. Absolutely sensational in getting our people to connect with those in the homeless squats or those that are sleeping underneath the bridges, underneath toilet blocks and in and around those areas which normally would not be inhabited by anybody. We've actually developed a concept of concierge care. So when our guests come through to us, they are met and introduced to a concierge person who then begins a journey with them, which takes them through the various services that are available in Alfred's. These include the beauty salon, where there's hairdressing, clothes drying, washing machine. There's a kitchen, which is virtually serving a la carte meals done by a professional restaurateur on a Wednesday. We have a library service, a computer lab. We have Flair on Alfred's, which is all new clothes, nothing secondhand. So our guests can come and shower, shave, get refreshed and focused, and get clothes that we would normally wear ourselves. And most of all, they can get food and treatment, which to many other of those that come to us, they find it to be quite uncomfortable and quite different. But when they exit us and go back into society, skilled, employable, whole of mind, in a situation where they're living in accommodation which is to a standard that is suitable to most people in Australia, and that way we know that we've had successful outcomes. Our mission is simply empowering people today for a better tomorrow. And when we see people breaking out of those cycles, coming back into society, functional, whole, complete, full of the Holy Spirit, loving God, we have seen a great outcome. To those partners that are out there that have been working with us, we say thank you. To the faceless community that you may never see, those who have donated, those who are involved in providing professional services for free, those who are giving cash donations, you have made a huge difference to those in our community that you will not normally encounter. So on their behalf, thank you.
Yes, as I'm driving home, we'll be thinking about the guys that I've met during the week and worry about them. Not quite sure what to do about that, whether to come back down and see them. I almost feel like I want to come back down to the soup kitchen tonight and have another meal and say hello. Just the importance of the people to care, you know, just the importance of people to say hello to someone. If you're catching a train with the same people every day, every week of the year, say hello to one of them. Let them know your name. a quick hello, let someone know that you are there and you're connected with them. It's really important. Amazing experience. I don't know if I'd like to do it again. So I'm really tired, sore, dirty, want to have a shower, shave, get some decent food. That's great, but there are people that won't be able to do that in a couple of hours' time like I can. I just want to take away from this the importance of connection. Thinking about other people and realising that you that have enough really need to help those that have nothing in whatever small way you can.
So with Christmas on our doorstep and hearts open, we invite you to reach out and help someone this Christmas. It's easy to make a difference. Something so small can make such a change, or even better, help someone out of the rut they may have fallen into. So what can you do to help? Well, there's plenty of things. Donate your time to a charity. There's a stack of places over Christmas looking for willing hands to make and serve meals at a number of soup kitchens and drop-in centres around town. Make an effort to connect with someone you wouldn't normally talk to. A conversation. A how you going? Can I help you? Would you like me to shout you a coffee? Most people won't bite, and the interaction will help build what could already be a low self-esteem. And then there's always cash. Support those who have an infrastructure in place to help those in need daily. CityCare Brisbane requires donations to increase its services to the homeless. All donations are tax deductible. You can make an impact this Christmas. Thanks for watching Under the Stars. Stay safe, take care, have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Reach out, reach out.
Have a crown and a relic.
Yeah, go on, Julie.